1453, the Ottomans occupied Constantinople, and then the Ottoman Empire continued expanding. Ottomans became the dominant force between Europe and Asia. And as you see here on the map, all these countries, all these areas became part of the Ottoman Empire for 5 centuries. For 4 centuries, Greece was just a small and distant part of this huge empire. It was not until 1770 that the Greeks started thinking to fight for their independence. That was the year that Theodoros Kolokotronis, one of the greatest leaders of the Greek Revolution, was born. And it was in northern Peloponnese, in Vostitsa, where Paleon Patron Germanos and all the other Greek leaders of Peloponnese met, and they decided to start the Greek Revolution in March 1821, although they had no support at all. Kolokotronis sends messengers all over Peloponnese to spread the news, the exciting news about the Greek Revolution. Greece did not have a professional army back then, and they knew the revolution would only be successful with the help and support of all people, all Greeks. So the army of the Greek Revolution included mainly proud and brave farmers, fighting wearing their fustanella. Laskarina Bubulina, Georgios Karaiskakis, Marcos Botzaris, and Andreas Miaoulis are only some of the most important figures of the Greek Revolution. These heroes fought bravely against the trained Turkish army, winning very difficult battles, like the Battle of Dervenakia against Thramali. The extent of this specific Ottoman defeat became proverbial in Greece, where a defeat is still referred as Katastrophe του Δράμαλη, Δράμαλης disaster. After 400 years of Ottoman slavery, and against all odds, Greece managed to retrieve its freedom and become an independent country. Πότε παλικάρια να ζούμε στα στενά, μοναχή σαν...